teachers to really just, in this worship, reflect on where it is that God has asked us to turn to our sisters for help, asked us to turn to Him for His guidance. And I invite you all to just mark the sign of our faith together, to enter into His presence and to praise Him and worship Him for His plan for us. Allow Him to really just overtake us in what it is that we're planning, overtake us in what we're discerning for, and ask Him to just guide us together as we praise together, as we say in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Come, Holy Spirit.
Bye.
sisters, the Lord has gathered us together, allowed us to pray and worship together. And as we bring this worship to a close, I ask you all to just open your hearts to Him, call out His name, and praise Him, worship Him, and really call out to Him and tell Him, glorify Him, worship Him, and tell Him what a beautiful name it is.
Thank you.
we continue to praise, glorify, and worship you. In this space where we share the room, we share our souls, our hearts, and our worship with our sisters. We just ask you, Father, to always guide us in all that we do, and all that we desire, and all that we hope to achieve, Father. Guide us in everything that is, everything that is that's in our life, and whether it's to glorify you or things that may be blocks for us, just continue to guide us in all of these things. And may we continue to search the hearts of our sisters, to continue to search for community with our sisters, to just always bless and guide us always. And as we end this worship, we just come to you, Father, and pray the prayer that you've taught us through your Son, as you say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. And Holy Mother, may you guide us, protect us in your mantle of blue, as we say, Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. As we give all glory back to our God, all glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. In the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Thank you, Pebbles, for leading us into worship, and thank you also for our music ministry in New York, for providing the music, right? Again, at this point, I'll invite everyone, at least for 10, 12 seconds, let's unmute ourselves and say hello, good morning, good afternoon to everyone. Don't invite us, let's greet one another, what a beautiful day today is, right? Yeah. Hello.
Hello.
Hi.
Good afternoon,
New York.
Good afternoon from New York.
Carolina.
Good afternoon,
Carolina.
Good afternoon, Miss K.
Hello from Texas.
It's good to hear that even though you are sitting in your room or in your sala, wherever you are, that you're hearing another person's voice, and it's a reminder, an affirmation that you are not alone, right? That you are journeying with your fellow sisters. I'll also invite you to open your videos so that we can see one another. We can see your wonderful faces, okay? So with that, without any further ado, now let's try to understand. As I've said, we're launching the Mary Circle today, this very day. And so let's try to understand what this program is about, why we're here, and what's going to happen after this, right? So at this point, let's see and hear the overview or brief welcome from our dear country servant about what's happening today, our launch of Mary Circle. Let's welcome our country servant, Brother Ed Yamba.
Thank you, Kay. Good day to all of you, wherever you are, whatever state you are in. Magandang umaga, tanghali, hapon. Good day to all of you. My dear woman of God, peace be with you. Please smile naman. I want you to smile. I want you to be happy. I want you to be excited of this new program. I welcome you, this Mary Circle program, to our community. This is another exciting evolution that will be a part of our Live Christ, Share Christ mission. Another offering to our Mother Church. I honor you all for opening this sacred space to provide support for special women who have special needs. I look at Mary's Circle as a great avenue to where these special women, like seasoned professionals, 36 years and midlife years, young single moms, young divorced and old, other special situation, can find holy role models and anchors to standing for heaven. The gift of womanhood indeed continue to amaze me as you multiply your tribes in unimaginable ways. Truly, our Blessed Mother guides you as you are her favored daughters. In particular, I honor the women of New York and our singles who labored to make this Mary Circle truly happen today. You're such a great gift of our community. You're like the fresh lilies of Esther who ushers Pentecost. Thank you. You know who you are. And you bring freshness and a spirit of revival to our women who are daughters of our Blessed Mother. I have heard about your moving forward programs for the rest of the year and your plans to immediately raise a critical mass to jumpstart this Mary Circle. God be praised for each one of you. So I want this, please do this. I want all of you who are involved in jumpstarting this special project, put a heart emoji now in your screens for you to be recognized. Okay? Let's all unmute ourselves and shout out, thank you! Do that now. Ron, thank I don't you. See your heart.
Thank you.
Thank you. And we love you too. We love you to this woman of great hearts and say yes, yes, and yes. God be praised for each one of you and for all of you who made it today a welcoming Mary Circle. I love you all. And I close with a short prayer. Father, I lift up to you all of these women whom you have given to our community. You have truly endowed our community with the gift of these women. We thank you for each of them and ask that you bless and protect the work of their hands. I ask this through the intercession of your Mother Mary. Amen. God bless you all. I thank you and have a good day.
Thank you, Brother Ed. Thank you for the welcome message for all of us and an introduction sort of message for our Mary Circle, the very program that we are launching today. My dear sisters, if you were listening to Brother Ed, this is part of what I'm trying to say is the mission is growing. This is part of us expanding the mission. Now, the gifts that we have received from God through MFC and LCSC, where we're opening doors to reach out to more people, especially to women of special cases, right? It's Mary Circle is basically a program for women, and the name it speaks for itself, right? Mary Circle, when you're part of this, you belong in the circle of Mary, right? You're part of that special inner circle of our Blessed Mother. And when you're part of that, of course, you're part of the also the inner circle of Jesus. So what a great gift and a blessing that is. And I've been reading this one article. This Mary Circle is, as I've said, as we've been always saying, it's a program for women, right? Where we journey with them, we journey with our fellow women. And in our world today, you know, there's incoherence right now with womanhood. The very simple question of what is a woman is hardly being answered today. No one can, the secular minds cannot answer it today, but but then with, and so what am I trying to say? There are so many thoughts in my head right now because of how good Mary's Circle is. But with the question, what is a woman, right? In this program, we'll answer the question. No, we'll find the answer in Jesus. We'll find the answer in Mary, right? Because God created men to be male and female, and that He created woman not second, but last. Now, there is an article I've been reading. He said there, the author said that God created woman not second, but last. And that is to mean that women is the pinnacle of creation. Women is the crown of creation. But that is not to put make the woman proud and put her above men, the male, but also to make them complement to one another. No, but I am digressing, moving much forward. But anyway, this afternoon, we would just want to celebrate our womanhood. Thank everyone for the gift of who you are as women of God. So we'll like to show with you, we'd like to present with you this introductory video for Mary's Circle. And then from there, we'll start our program.
You women who are mothers, you have sheltered human beings within yourselves in a unique experience of joy and travail. This experience makes you become God's own smile upon the newborn child, the one who guides your child's first steps, helps it grow, and who is the anchor as the child makes its way along the journey of life.
Thank you, women who are wives. You irrevocably join your future to that of your husband in a relationship of mutual giving at the service of love and life.
Welcome, women who are daughters and women who are sisters, into the heart of the family and then of all society. You bring the richness of your sensitivity, your intuitiveness, your generosity, and fidelity.
Thank you, women who work. You are present and active in every area of life, social, economic, cultural, artistic, and political. In this way, you make an indispensable contribution to the growth of a culture which unites reason and feeling, to a model of life ever open to the sense of mystery, to the establishment of economic and political structures ever more worthy of humanity.
Thank you, consecrated women, following the example of the greatest of women, the Mother of Jesus Christ, the Incarnate Word. You open yourselves with obedience and fidelity to the gift of God's love. You help the Church and all mankind to experience a spousal relationship to God, one which magnificently expresses the fellowship which God wishes to establish with His creatures.
Thank you, every woman, for the simple fact of being a woman. Through the insight which is so much part of your womanhood, you enrich the world's understanding and help to make human relations more honest and authentic.
Oh, that is such a great introduction. Just shows how women are gifts, how women are empowered. And as we continue with our program, we would like to look in. So that's from there. We're looking into the women in our community as well, and how they're involved in a lot of activities, be it with service and sometimes fellowship as well. So it's also service, but there's also a fun side to it. So as we continue, let's get a glimpse of what our women in the community have been involved in the recent years as well.
Place where I reside, when I'm at the stage of shaking my head as I look back on my life, when I'm halfway through the grieving but not quite through the end, then I cannot see the ending or which road I'm supposed to take.
Thank you to the support team for that wonderful video. Actually, it's always nice, right, to reminisce and look back on what the year has been or what the recent years has been. But at this point, we would like to actually move forward as we also go into reflections or what our other sisters can share about themselves. We will call in a few sisters actually to share their life experiences. They actually come from different walks of life, from different backgrounds. Earlier on, we showed a video of women from different backgrounds, right? And these women that who will be sharing with you today are also coming from different backgrounds, different perspectives. But they share one thing in common, and that is their love for God, a devotion to Mary, to Mother Mary, and to the community. So that's what brings them together. So without further ado, we will start with our first sharer. Let's call in one of our sisters. She's from Queens, New York, and she's under the MFC Handmaids Unit 2. She's a devoted mother and also a devoted church servant. So let's welcome Shirley Sabino.
Brothers and sisters, my name is Shirley Sabino, a proud single mom and a physical therapist living in Woodside, Queens, New York. I was an active member of the church back in the Philippines. I serve as a lector commentator joined youth ministries, and participated in pro-life missions in my hometown. Sometimes I also helped clean up the church and assisted in soliciting for donations to sustain for our parish expenses. I lived in the slum area in Navotas. Despite not having a stable income, I was the family breadwinner, so at a very young age. I knew I had to do everything within my means to provide for my family. My parents cannot provide for my education, so my aunt in New York sent me to school to get a degree and help my family. Through persistent prayers and trust in God, I came to the U.S. in 2011. It was such a blessing, but at the same time, one of the hardest decisions I had to take. It was difficult to be separated from my family, especially from my daughter, who was only 7 years old at the time. It's really one of my biggest challenges in life, as I ask myself, how can I guide my daughter through her spiritual life if I leave her? How can I spend time and show love to my family if I am miles away from them? Can I become an active member of the church even if I'm in the U.S.? Just have faith in God. That's all what I'm thinking. Me, my aunt, and my uncle used to pray the rosary every night and go to church every Sunday. But I know I'm missing something. And then one day I realize I have to be active in serving the Lord again. I joined the MFC last May of 2015 when I was invited by Sister Lisa Maneja. Since then, my faith in God and Blessed Mother became even stronger. These are the things that were missing in my life. In spite of all the graces and blessings that I've received from God, I know I have to serve more to build a strong relationship with my brothers and sisters in Christ. Being a member of MFC, I found the love, affection, and warmth that I was missing from my distant family. From this community, I was able to evangelize and to share the gospel knowledge to other people. To know that I am not alone and my brothers and sisters in Christ were praying for me and for one another. Such a wonderful feeling that aside from your family and friends, my MFC family is praying for me as well, especially in times of trials, illness, loss, and disappointments in life. In May of 2019, my daughter Bea came to the U.S. It was the most ecstatic feeling that I've ever felt. I thank the Lord for this most awaited moment in my life, seeing my daughter again after 7 years. Since then, my life has changed. I grew more in love and faith in God, but challenges happened. Being a single mom living in New York, working a full-time job and having to take care of my child is one hard challenge. I have to squeeze my time in between work and running errands. I know to myself that this shouldn't affect my presence in the community. So what I usually do is to bring my daughter with me during prayer meetings and gatherings. As a mother, I want her to be closer to God, to know Him well, and to share what she's learning in her own little ways. We prayed every night and asked God's will so we could serve His people even more. One day, a parish priest in St. Sebastian Church asked my daughter to join the Legion of Mary and to become a lector. Like our Blessed Mother, she did not waste time saying yes to the invitation. Since then, I also became a senior Legion of Mary and a minister of the Eucharist, giving our time, talents, and treasures in serving the parish. These are the things that I'm longing for. God has given me this opportunity to serve Him again and His people. In spite of these challenges as a mother, I was able to raise my daughter with respect, trust, and in love with God. How can I strengthen my evangelization work as a mother, as a family, and as a community? For me, I have to accept that I am a sinner and that I need God. I need to humble myself as a mother, daughter, and a sister in Christ so that I can create an impact by serving God, spending time praying, studying His words, and in fellowship with the Holy Spirit to solidify God's truth in us. I need to know Him more by reading the scriptures so we can love Him more. If we love God, we can trust Him more and surrender everything as God uses all circumstances for His purpose and glory. Never allow yourself to sink in moments of sadness and disappointments in life. I need to dedicate my life to knowing and loving Jesus so we can discover the amazing purposes He has for our lives. We can stop worrying about what we lack and know that His acceptance is all we need. No matter what we are facing right now, it helps to keep in mind that God is in complete control. Wherever you are, Jesus will manifest His love not only in your current situations, but also through others, and in my case, through the invitation of my MFC handmade sister in Christ that led me to the Missionary Families of Christ handmaids. Thank you, and may the good Lord bless us all.
Thank you, Sis Shirley. That was indeed a wonderful and inspiring sharing. It's not easy to be a single parent, but with God, nothing is impossible and nothing is insurmountable, I would say. We then would go to our next sharer. She is also from Queens, and I'm happy to say that she is from our household. In our household amongst us, we fondly call her Miss D. So let's all welcome Edith Santos.
Hi, good afternoon. How are you? I hope everything is okay with you. My name is Edith and I am from Queens. Let me tell you about my journey in knowing God. I came from a big family who are originally Catholics, but some became Christians through marriage. I myself, before knowing this community, did not have much knowledge about the Word of God. I didn't study in a Catholic school, so my little knowledge only came from an after-school religion class from our church back then. I was focused on my studies, graduated college, and yet I'm still a less knowledgeable Catholic, I may say. Only when I work in an airline company that a co-worker gave me a booklet of daily readings and reflections. It inspired me to read the Bible this time. Afterwards, I started to pray on my own regularly, but then my work schedule and heavy workload interfered with my interest to seek more knowledge about God. So I worked and worked until I got a chance to work here in the USA or in the US. Being a newbie here in New York, I had no major activities to do. It's a home work home schedule, and I had a good career and a loving family, but still I felt something was missing. For sure, God heard me. A co-worker invited me to join a teaching for single men and women, and they call it Christian Life Program or CLP. I got interested, and that year was 1999. The start of my busy life with this newfound group called Singles for Christ, or we call it SFC. It is under the umbrella group. It was called before Couples for Christ. It's CFC, and now it became MFC. I'm sorry. It is called Missionary Families of Christ. I became a servant leader of household, which is the smallest unit of this ministry, for several years, and in spite of my busyness with day work, thank God, I fulfilled this responsibility of guiding my sisters. Later on, most of our leaders decided to step down to give way to the new generation of members to stand up and lead. But we remain at their back, ready to help when needed. We then move on from SFC and transition to handmaids. Handmaids is another ministry of MFC. It is composed of single and married ladies, and I think that was year 2016. In this community, we have weekly household meetings. If you're a leader, you will have two weekly meetings. We call it the upper household and the lower household. We have monthly assemblies, we have yearly conferences, we have numerous teachings and community activities that either brought out or enhanced the hidden skills and gifts we have. All of this truly made me busy. Yes, made me tired, but happy. I still remember the happy moments we had after each activity, even if it will end up late, late night. Members became closer and found a family within us. Everyone is always ready to help, to guide, and to lead. What a wonderful environment to come home to, especially after a tiring work day. I truly learned a lot about God and my faith in this community. I found many friends, sisters, and brothers who motivated me to serve more. The former lazy person and a crybaby became a ready-to-serve person, became open to know and to seek more. I became confident in myself and in my faith. I became a stronger person and with a mindset to always try to be positive, always try to be understanding, always try to be patient on every issue I will face, on every situation I get into, and with people I meet. With God's presence in my life and with the community's guidance, I was transformed, as we say, to a better version of myself. I also noticed that with the many of God's guided works of the community and regular teachings, that something is missing, thought that I had before, knowing the community was gone. Why? Because I found that what is missing? God's presence in my life. So now, since He's with me, I don't have that feeling anymore. Daily prayer and inspirational music easily soften and calm my troubled mind and heart. I easily say a prayer now or sing praise song whenever I need and wherever I may be. Whether I'm on the street, I can sing. I became more appreciative even to the smallest gift I got from God. I learned to listen to other people in various faiths and curious to ask about many of their practices and belief. I have a lot of office mates with different faith, and I tend to ask them too. And amazingly, didn't affect or question my own beliefs. I became bold in sharing God's works and words to others when the chance permits. It also became a habit to regularly read the daily readings and gospel from my cell phone on my way to work, with many people around me and with noisy environment on my train ride. Yes, on my train ride. Strange, right? My secret? I will start to listen to the audio version of my reading on my way to the train or while waiting for the train, and then read them again on the train. I sometimes wrote my own reflections as well. I also share the reading links to my family members. Happiness overloads whenever I get a reply of heart or thumbs up emojis on the messages I sent to them. They even put a smile on my face whenever they text back any form of appreciation to God, because before, they're not like that. They are so used now to receiving any info about our faith from me. They are so used to hear me leading a prayer for every meal we will all share. You know what? I'm just waiting for that time. That time that everyone will be comfortable to lead a prayer for the family. And I hope it will be near soon. I always pray for all of them for a change of heart and to have a relationship with God and experience the kind of happiness I have knowing Him. The community led me to use my God-given gifts for service. While still with SFC, I became a member of our choir that serve in Filipino and English masses on some churches in Queens, and we even experienced singing at St. Patrick's Church and other churches in Manhattan. We also engaged with church parishioners in serving at soup kitchens as well as evangelization activities. I became a catechist for 3 years until I got a physical injury that led me to slow down, rest, and then take some time off. Though this service requires hard work, it motivates me to study more and to prepare each Sunday to face my young students. This service was one of the services that I love to do again when my time permits. To aid my teachings to young kids, I join a group of catechists who virtually meet a priest and have the monthly Bible study. But my current work consumes most of my time lately, so I sometimes miss the Bible study, and I'm sorry to say, our household meetings. So now I'm thinking, when I decide to stop working, I will continue to study and document each book of the Bible, my major project. I also want to do the service I love most, and you know what is it, right? And maybe another service that God will lead me to do. So sisters, continue to seek and have and always have our Lord in your life. Thank you and have a blessed afternoon.
Thank you very much, Ms. D. That was indeed inspiring. It's good to know. I think a lot of us can relate being a busy working woman here in New York, right? It's difficult in itself, but to be able to, despite that, create an impact in other people's lives and to our loved ones, that is really something. For our last leg, last sharer, let me turn it over to Ludette to introduce her.
Hello, everybody. Last but not the least, the third sharer for today is Mary Bernadette John. I am honored that she is a member of my household. She will outline her life of service in the church and the community. So without further ado, let us welcome Mary Bernadette John.
Peace be with you, everyone. My name is Mary Bernadette John. I'm originally from St. Vincent and the Grenadines. My parish is St. Francis of Assisi, St. Blaise in Crown Heights, Brooklyn. I am involved in the catechist, as a catechist at grade 7, pre-confirmation class, the bereavement ministry, Legion of Mary, choir, and extraordinary minister for the shut-in. As a catechist, it's my pleasure to introduce children to the Catholic faith, and I also talk to them about their guardian angel, which most of them haven't heard of a guardian angel and even know that they have their own personal guardian angel. As a homework, I ask them to write a letter to their guardian angel, introducing themselves to their guardian angel. For example, I ask them to find out if it's a male or female guardian angel, and you know, to tell them about their interests in school or their activities, and some even draw their own personal guardian angel from their imagination. And other things, like I teach them about the corporal works of mercy and the spiritual works of mercy. And I always emphasize the Ten Commandments and the Beatitudes. And I say the Ten Commandments is things that you shouldn't do. And the Beatitudes is things that you should try to do, like being kind and, you know, friendly with others. And for example, getting off when you're on the bus and get off the bus to give a seat to an elderly. For bereavement, I have to help families to plan the funeral mass. And when people are grieving, they don't want to think about the first reading or the second reading or what songs they're going to sing. So I'm there for that, to encourage them and help them to do the last loving things that they're going to do for their family. And some of them have been frequently in the church, so they forget their faith or the teachings of the church. So I have to remind them that they can't just spread the ash anywhere and on the ocean, or, you know, put it in a vial around their neck, that they should put the remain on in the ground or in a mausoleum. For extraordinary minister, the shutting, I take to about 4 or 5 people at my parishioners at their home. And while I go, I ask Jesus to touch anyone who needs to be touched when I pass with the Blessed Sacrament. And one of the lady that I take communion to is now in the nursing home and journeying back to the Father's house. And I continue to take communion and be with her to hold her hand and try to keep her calm. I joined Singles in 2014, and I was introduced to it by parishioner at the time who was at St. Francis, my friend May. It was an 8-week program, CLS program. And after that, I joined, was encouraged to join Sponsored Mass, which is the third Sunday at St. John the Baptist, and Brother Sal was, you know, like our spiritual director who encouraged us and introduced us to others' activity at St. John. And we used to go to the Taizé Friday, I think, once a month. And we were all happy to be there to learn more about our faith, to grow as Christian young people, and to stay close to Jesus. The transition to handmade was a smooth one, which take place in 2016. And Tita Ida was our leader and encourage us and support us and remind us when we have household. Because of the pandemic, we join on Zoom and we continue to this day. Our sisterhood is an awesome one. We respect each other and support each other within the household and outside of the household. And case in point, when my mom had a stroke and when she passed away and to the present, my sisters continue to encourage me and support me, and two other sisters lost. One lost their mom and one lost their dad. So it was a collective grieving time for all of us, and all the other sisters encourage us because they also experienced loss one stage of their life or another. I am blessed to be with this group of sisters. We are a little army fighting to win souls for Jesus by the way we serve him and support each other to keep our eyes focused on the Lord. We do all this with the support of our Blessed Mother, Mama Mary. Thank you, everyone. God bless.
Thank you, Mary B. Okay, I want to thank all our sharers for today. Thank you for your inspiring and meaningful messages. We hope it has made an impact on all of you. And now at this juncture, we're having a reflection song to be led by the Singles. Take it away, Singles.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much, beautiful and talented singles. My God, that was so beautiful. And they're so talented with the flute. Maybe we have an activity just for the flute and the violin. We know somebody who knows how to do the violin. That was good. Very, very good. Thank you so much, singles. You have filled our heart with so much joy. And just to kneel and to glorify and to offer this afternoon for Mama Mary. Thank you so much. We have been so inspired with all the sharings and with all the, with all the information about Mary's Circle, but we're not done yet. We still have to hear from an inspirational message from Sister Maribel. She requested to be introduced as a mother of six and a grandmother of four, a full-time worker, coordinator, Handmaids USA, member of the MFC National Council, in charge of MFC Women's Formation. That's no mean feat, sisters. But most of all, she always have the heart of a missionary. So due to unforeseen circumstances, she cannot be with us this afternoon, but she has a video. Roll it away.
So congratulations, dear women of God, dear sisters in Christ. You are providing a divine space for these special women. And what we witness today is a revelation of God's love for his women and his commission to the church about how he wants to care for his great creation of this special women. And one could tell and feel how our Father honors and assigns women at every point in his divine plan. And what we've seen today is very encouraging because it highlights the incredible gift of how single women testify to the truth of the theological virtues of faith, hope, and charity. We cannot afford to overlook the matchless worth of caring for these special women who are on a heroic and saintly journey. They are a wonderful and indispensable witness to God's utmost divine mercy, which is love and compassion for the least and struggling yet courageous living that they are in this journey in life. They seek God first. They aspire to live honorably. They are role models, and they share victorious lives of grace, love, and pure joy. So I can't help but recall what Proverbs say about these ideal women. It says, many, many women do noble things, but you surpass them all. Charm is deceptive and beauty is fleeting. But the woman who fears the Lord is to be praised. Give her the reward she has earned and let her works bring her praise to at the city gates, the heavenly Jerusalem. So I praise and thank God and honor each one of you. Ave Maria Purissima. And at this juncture, I wish to honor and give thanks to our women from Handmaids and Singles, specifically of New York, for their labor of love. You're all beautiful women, and God be praised for you all. Thank you so much.
A round of applause. I know we are so excited for the next next months of what is going to happen, what are the activities for Mary's Circle. So I'm going to give you Sister Dolly Powell, our chapter servant of MFC Handmaids New York. She's going to announce all the activities for the rest of the year. Take it away, Tita Dolly. Unmute yourself, po.
Somebody has to unmute me. Okay. All right. Thank you so much. Yes. For the next coming months, we have the following activities. We have for July, these are Merry Circle 2023 planned activities. For July, we have formation launch during our national MFC conference. We have also one in August, which is about vocation talk. That will be, this is May, June, July, August, three months from now. In October, we have Living Victorious. And in November, we have Love in Any Language. So sisters, including our brothers who are here with us, what's for the next coming significant events of our Merry Circle? So welcome everyone. Let's await what is very inspiring and very beautiful activities worth attending and participating. Thank you and God bless.
God bless.
Thank you, Tita Dali, and I hope you're as excited as I am to look forward to our activities. So if you know of somebody of this same special situation, you can send their names to anybody, your head or anybody that, you know, we will invite them with a grateful heart. We are now about to close, but this person who's gonna deliver the closing prayer is a very is a mother of four and famously as the wife of Rebrov, who is the MFC zone coordinator for the Mid-North. She's a fellow Cebuana and a dear friend. She's also gonna talk about the conference a little bit, just not to snooze you. Please welcome with a big round of applause, Sister Ella Rebar.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much, Sister Ja. And what a wonderful, wonderful session that we had today. I am so glad that we finally have this platform for our younger women, right? The younger women in our lives. I think that this is indeed a call that they've been waiting. So sisters, I'm tasked today to talk about the conference, as Sister Dali mentioned earlier. That's the conference both for the national couples as well as the handmaids of the Missionary Families of Christ. It's going to be in July 21, 22, and 23 in Chicago, Illinois. So it's in a Marriott Lincolnshire hotel. And we invite everyone who's here, those who are handmaids already of MFC, and also those who are just newly invited here. We invite you to join us in our conference. It's going to be a very beautiful conference. We're going to have a very powerful speaker and in a retreat-like session on the first day in July 21st. So what I just wanted to let you know is that registration is still ongoing. It's still open, definitely. And for those who have already registered, we invite you to book your hotels already if you have not booked your hotel rooms yet. Last time that I checked, the double beds, the rooms with double beds have already been booked or sold out, but our conference coordinator, Sister Tess, is still working on requesting for more rooms with two double beds. So, you know, if you have not booked yet, just keep on checking and requesting for those two double beds. And then also for our handmaids who are not able to join us in the conference, we ask that you please, please donate. maybe donate a page in the advertorial in the souvenir program. That way you can help, you know, help us all, the conference itself, for the expenses, the cost, and also be a part of us, be a part of the conference in spirit. Okay, so we have prepared a very beautiful socials night for the handmaids and the women in our community, which will be on July 21st. The theme would be Victorian high tea. Attire would be kind of smart chic or Sunday's best dresses, which we can accessorize with fancy hats or what we call fascinators, pearls and lace. So it's, you know, girly, girly time for the women. So just that's just appropriate. You'll know more about it through your area coordinators. They have the specifics for that, as well as the different activities that you can participate in during that night. Now, at this point, I'm also tasked to do the closing prayers. So without further ado, let us put ourselves in the presence of our Lord. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. Father God in heaven, you are the true source of hope, joy, love, and peace. You're a refuge and our strength, our savior and our friend. You're indeed our Father and our God. Father, you have always been with us in our journey, personally and communally as MFC handmaids, specifically through our work in evangelization and community development in handmaids. Truly, what a gift this group has been to each of us. It has been our source of support, love, and inspiration. We are grateful for the friendship and true spirit of sisterhood which blossomed through our fellowship with one another, of worshiping together and serving together. Thank you, Father, for giving us this platform, this Mary's Virtual Coffee Club, where we can gather and talk more, communicate more, interact more, and learn more about the many things we can do to inspire, to be a channel of your healing grace, to give hope, and to just be a blessing, and to help this world become a better place to live in. And as we proclaim and declare to the world your unending love, your unconditional love, please empower us and equip us. Continue to use us mightily and powerfully that we may be effective in doing this work with the help of Mama Mary, of course, and the power of the Holy Spirit. Father, we lift up to you once again this launching of Mary's Circle, where we cater and address the specific needs of these beautiful group of young women, whether they're seasoned professionals or in their midlife years or young single moms and maybe divorced, annulled, or women in special situations. Affirm in us, O Lord, that this special program launch we are promoting is coming from your leading. And as we continue to discern on how to propagate this work, allow us to be mindful and to be eager of doing the specific tasks that is needed to do and make this launch successful. Father, this is your work, and we are glad to be chosen to work with you in this vineyard. Thank you again for the privilege to be of service to you and your people. We love you, Lord. We honor you and we glorify you forever and ever. Amen. Glory be to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. In the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Thank you so much, Ella. Kay, do you have something to say just to close this meeting? She's not in.
I believe we are good po. I'm here, Tita. I just turned off my video because of my internet. But I'm here. I think we're good. Thank you, everyone, for joining. And see you in the next activities as Sister Dali have announced. Okay. Good afternoon.
So
God bless. Enjoy the weekend.
Happy Feast of Our Lord's Ascension.
Easter.
When I think of sunlight piercing through the clouds to paint the perfect sky, think of the silver light.
Oh, naka-pink na ako, ha?
When I think of streams that we've
seen, I forget to take pictures!
Ay! Pwede pa po. Kaya lang, don't leave yet.
Ayaw ka lang!
That's okay po.
Ha?
It's okay.
Yeah, who's taking pictures?
Mistaking? Para naka-smile naman ako.
Okay. Sige po, I can take it. Yeah. Will you turn on the videos?
Those who are still here, turn on your videos. Okay. At the count of?
1, 2, 3. Thank you. Yeah. Thank you. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you.
Thank you. Ba't ba nakalimutan ko, Giselle?
Picture. Okay, we're
I was thinking about it.
Kami po, we're not into it. Kaya walang nag-remind.
I was thinking about it kaya lang pagkatapos nung dasal, nawala na.
At least po, nakuhanan yung pink shirt ni
Anyway, hi, Wade.